Okay, I got a message from someone, and I need to check this real quick. Wait, what does this say? Have fun dreaming about Zelda. She's out again. Well, any case, hey everybody, CoolPika here, and welcome back to the Legend of Zelda Let's Play of the Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword. Oh, la 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 la. In the last part, we entered the dungeon, explored a bit, and we got ourselves a vacuum cleaner with the power of Billy Mays. Yep, okay, yeah, this tile's gonna be doing something Billy Mays related, huh. I bet you right now. So, of that, whatever the case is, this tile's gonna have the name Billy Mays in the title. And in this part, we're gonna go ahead and backtrack a bit, because we actually can now put our vacuum cleaner to use, even though that it's not called a vacuum cleaner because it's a Gus Bellows, but I like to call it a vacuum cleaner. However, it's a vacuum cleaner that doesn't suck, it blows. Oh. Of course, Parasite's here. First thing you want to do is you can now get rid of that block that was actually in the way. And not only that, you want to go blow off that as well. Not only there's the box, there's also that switch over there. So you want to move the box and put it over the switch. And something will happen when you do that. So with that being said, go ahead and push that. And that's a door opens. So now we can head inside to another door. And we're gonna skip those dragons, and haha, you missed. Haha, trolley, 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 trolley. Adjusting my sound real quick. Alright. Here we are in itself in another room. Pufferfish. Okay, push him out of the way. Obviously, you can see here in this room, there is going to be definitely a time shift stone here, so we will be working with some time concepts here, just so you already know what we're going to be working on. Rhetorical on what I'm saying here, but because I couldn't get the ledge. I fail. Okay, as you also know, I've also went and repaired my shield. And for a little bit of an information, we are probably not gonna get the final upgrade for the wooden shield because what's coming up. So, I'm just pointing it out there now. I'm not gonna tell you why though, but you'll know why when we do. But I won't bother much about that right now. We're just now, so. Man, you know what? Bop goes the weasel. I gotta say, man, I have been slacking on uploads lately. I mean, seriously, like, I upload like 2 or 3 videos a week, and then the next week you get absolutely like nothing. You don't get like diddly squat. You can actually only upload like every other week. I tried actually recording the video. It's not been working out for me. So, here we are. We got our time shift stone. That. Put back in time once again and. Very amazing. And now we got these panels to work with. You blow these in a certain direction, it will move in that direction. So that's also worth noting. You can also blow them towards you from going put in luck. So, in this part of the section of the dungeon, you will have to work with the these pillars here in order to get to where you want to go. Actually, I'm just heading over here just to get this treasure chest, just so we can get it because we want to get everything we can. No, those aren't rare. Not likely to drop. I've only gotten the rare skulls. Okay, now for this door right here, you want to go ahead and blow on this propeller and the door will open right there. And get a good welcome. Huh. There we go, love the welcome. Let me return the favor for you. Haha! Stabbed you in right in the eye. Think you like that, huh? Well, you're robots. I'm not sure if robots feel, to be honest. Like have. Do robots actually feel? I don't know. Oh, I actually successfully hit that. So we have a new enemy right here, and he's gonna shoot a missile, and you want to deflect it with your shield, and then he'll let out these little guys that are basically like bombs. These could be really pretty hard to take out. If it takes long for you to take them out, they'll explode. That takes like 2 hits to take them out, so yeah. 2 missiles must be deflected in order to. Okay, so the next scene we gotta do here is go ahead and move the. That's close. That being said, safe, but I don't think you'll make that dumb jump, so you don't want to do that. Move it back over here, and yet you'll get onto the other side. Of course, we're gonna have more green welcomes here with this guy. But he was the one that got surprised, foiled by me. And more propel. Oh, okay. Here we go. Okay, now that's taken care of. We're gonna go ahead and open this door. Of course, we got dragons. Okay, I don't think we have to kill them. Definitely will. I'm gonna go ahead and blow that. I'm not letting you these guys get in the way. They're not. They're not getting in my way. There's bucks up here and. And then. Okay, let's go ahead and blow us over here. Oh, just a parasite. Okay, that's a heart. Okay, we can take that. I mean, I've already used my last potion off before recording this. Yeah, there we go. Wow. Talk about pretty progressive. Here, nothing actually. Oh, nuts. Yeah, nuts. And no, I do not mean these nuts. These nuts, I mean, I don't do that meme. I don't. One of the time stones are going to be in here. You may not be able to reach it, but you can reach it through the bars with your slingshot, so you can use that. Bye-bye, dragons, and we got some new enemies we're going to go up against. These can be a little bit annoying, but if you can pull this off correctly, hopefully you won't have much of a trouble. You want to use a gust blower on these enemies. You want to be able to stab. This one you could take, that crystal was a tongue sticking out, and that one you have to take out more easily. But however, for this one, you actually gotta thrust it. If you're not good with motion controls, you might have a bit of trouble with this guy, but, surprisingly, I actually did a bit better with this one, surprisingly. I guess I've been gotten a bit better with the motion control. So let's just go ahead and take whatever's inside this treasure box and dungeon map. So now we're set on. So now we're pretty much set on this stuff, and now we got our stuff ready. Now we know where Zelda is. Hopefully we'll finally meet her once soon, and hopefully I'm actually not. I am totally worthy. So that we're back in. Okay, I don't think I was supposed to go here. Yeah, this is the wrong room. Yeah, I went in the wrong room. I don't know what I was thinking there. Okay, yeah, this is the room we really want to go to. I pretty much always get these rooms mixed up. I'm not. And look at this. We are basically on the other side of this one room we once were. But so, now that we step on this treasure chest, we can open that up so we can actually come back here later. So for whenever we do need to backtrack. It's okay, we're making some progress now. I would assume if we're doing keep up this pace, it probably take this episode and probably the next episode to get to the dungeon. To get to the boss. So it definitely probably won't take long. So we're actually making some progress here. Good for us. Or good for me. You guys are just the one that are speculating. Oh, jelly blobs. Come here. Of course, we're gonna have to go through these transitions again because, apparently they need to remind us that we have to know what these are because they think we'll forget. You didn't hear it, but I farted. Yeah. And I should. Okay, we gotta. So now we're gonna be going through the. Someone goes through these shafts here. So we gotta. And we pretty much got ourselves like a nice little isolated room. So we have ourselves like an isolated room with a treasure chest here and some parasites, of course. Of course. The treasure chest will be a goddess plume. Nothing in this room, but that's a pretty cool room where you can get stuff. And what's also pretty cool we got here is we got a photo of like three robots here with a message. And that one in the middle looks like it's wearing a tie. He's probably like the president of this Lonero mining facility or something. I don't know. It's possible. The tie must have some kind of significance. But yeah, it does look like he's wearing a tie. That looks like a President LD unit. At least, that's how I look at it. So, there really isn't anything else in the shaft. There's just that treasure chest. So, that's everything you can get in that. That's actually everything you can get in. Yeah. Although, they do have rubies in some of those dead ends. Go ahead and recharge here. Besides, also, you see these yellow paths here? I didn't go over it, but you refer to this map a lot because these show you the paths you can actually walk on. So pay attention. I think I've lost the. Yeah, I'm totally not on the path. I have to refer to my map. Yep, we're going on the right way because this guy guy's on solid ground. Sad. Path over there we can go to. There really isn't necessarily anything over there. Where we want to go to is actually the sand area. Well, blow this over and there will be, of course, another shaft and a parasite. Okay. Alright, here, here we go. Some dead ends here. We got another... We can go... We now have another shaft we can now crouch toward... crawl in. Surprisingly fittable. Now, of course, we got more dead ends, so if you want to go to those dead ends and get rubies... We can... So they have that fed... That we got some cleaning to do, boys, girls. So with that being said, Billy Mays is here with a new astounding product, and we'll show you what the true power of the Ghost Fellas can truly do. Billy Mays here with a new astounding product. So now we're gonna put our new Ghost Fellas into action. The blower can actually. Can actually get clear sand from 20 a million miles away from here, disappearing into nothing, and reveal spiky areas. The pathways have never been so clear. I gotta work on the Billy Maze. So what we gotta do here is blow off all the sandy areas and actually. The more you look through these sandy areas, you can now see the spikes you got to watch out for. Well, you gotta watch out for that. Clear most of this out when we can reveal our path. So we gotta clear out most of these in order to reveal what our path is. You could likely get hurt. Boom, bingo. Okay, this is a dead end right here. Okay. What you know? We can go, this is our actual pathway. The whole time we could have gone that way. See that? Isn't that an astounding product? Okay. Okay, no, I'm not gonna shut up. I'm gonna stop trying to pass for Billy May. I'm not passing for Billy. Although as a kid, I see them as a guy that yells a lot. It's like, I'm yelling for no reason in my commercials. Always as a kid I did. Hallelujah, 20 rupees. Look how clean this path is. Well, it's sort of clean. But it's a start. We now have a path to get. You have another path. We can't open this. We're gonna do a bit more cleaning up here. We're missing something, alright. We're about to find out what. We are definitely missing. Probably the panel. Ah, there we are. There you are. There's the panel I've been looking for. I'll be over there in a jiffy. I get it, Fi. You don't need to remind me. Okay, opening that up, we have that. We got this door shift open. So now, okay, now we're getting somewhere. And we are literally on the other side of the room now, like the north, we're inside. Look at that. Look at all those detour routes we could take. And now, there's also a time shaft stone here. You can pretty much stab it or place a bomb to do it. Now you see that switch? While it's moving, it only goes in one direction. The only way you can stop it is if you hit that switch and start it over. So that's something you're gonna have to keep in mind. And as you can see on the other side, that's where Zelda's likely at. On the other side of that temple. So with that being said, we still have more things to do. You have seen more things. Like, we gotta get that time. We gotta get that cart over to the other side of this area. Flash that. Okay, there we go. That worked. Okay, this part we gotta be really careful. Likely screw them. If you want to make sure you're not, in order to avoid getting hit by those lasers, you can hide behind, you can camp behind this side of the. There we go. I've gotten good with these motion controls over the years of playing. So that's definitely working out for me. Well, now I'm being told where I can actually on the at the car. Aha, you can't hit me. And with that, we already taken care. Whoa, whoa! That would have been bad. Okay, that's better to process. And now we can actually open up another gate for us to actually So that's a bit helpful for us. We're making some progress. We might get much. We're not gonna get a lot done today than we thought we were. So yeah. Let's see how much we can get done. Kinda confident about how much we're gonna get done right now. Alright. Rest right here. Instead, we're gonna be rest. Okay, as you can see, we got more robots up ahead. And of course, there's also a door right there. Also leads to something. No, you can't go. And on the other side right there, we got a propeller right there that we can blow on. A little vacuum cleaner. Gale winds. The door. Let's see if we can... Neck of time, and we did it in the neck of time. Okay. And with that being said, we can. Ha!
we're gonna go forward. Move. Okay, he's going to move again. So now what we want to do is go ahead and head over to that door. Yeah, my hearts are seriously depleted. Of course, ugh, no potions. Ain't that a surprise, right? Yeah, I guess it's a surprise. Now we're here, we are in another room. We got like exhaust pipes like blowing up all over the place. Parasites all over the place. Parasites. Jelly blobs. Watch out for these exhaust pipes here. Okay, oh crap. Okay, that didn't kill me. That's good. I always thought that was gonna kill me. Oh man, crap! Oh, I can't really do this right. I'm gonna do a simple scene. To go, did it? Side by any chance? You're making me do this right. There we go. No. I really need a heal. Like that. Look, more basketball. I won't even try until we actually react to time, because that's definitely what we're gonna have to do. And we don't have to open the switch for it. I fought like the time. That's not where it is. I'm not even sure if you call it time shift. I don't need. I'm tired. I guess we could go ahead and scope out the place real quick. Okay, yeah, that's a dead end right there. That is a dead end, that right over there. Over there, okay, where is it? Okay, I think I see my Okay, I'm seeing it now. Yeah, I'm seeing it now. Okay, yep, there we go. I'm totally seeing it. It's over there. Where I flew my beetle to is right in that direction. So we do need to use that. I was in the right direction the whole time. Okay, yeah, we did need to go here. When I start figuring things out, and now I don't have the items necessarily to progress. Ha ha ha, nice. I only have bomb plants here. Oh, wait. Got any bombs? Oh, yep. Everything is in my prison. Everything has been provided to me by a barrel. There we go. Let's go ahead and throw him. Okay, there's probably something over here, but... No. Gust Bellows. You know what? I'm just gonna call a vacuum clearance at this point. Now, time to go back to the past. Hopefully no more mishaps. Okay, now we're gonna be here to do what we gotta do. Oh, crap. Slice, death. Now you know how Bill Cipher feels. Okay, as you can see here, we got these TV screens that I really like looking at. Those are pretty cool. Gotta say, I really do love this dungeon. I mean, it's a pretty cool gimmicky dungeon with, like, this technical stuff. Which, this is stuff you don't usually see in a Zelda game. It just does. There are now other scenes that we got. So, like, I want to go ahead and blow up these. Gonna go ahead and blow up these, entirely go in. That one doesn't dip. That one exactly end. Now, see those right there with those robots? Faces implant with, like, two robots, three robots. Over here. Here we are gonna have one robot. See how these are arranged? You want to remember that for what you're gonna do, go be doing up ahead. Because what we're gonna be doing is gonna be on the other side of that direction. Well, once here, Mr. out of here. Joy to take care of. Success. Okay, now that's done. We're gonna go ahead and get our vacuum cleaner up and we're gonna get our vacuum cleaner blow it like all the way over there. Come on. Yeah man. Alright. Play with me. There we go. Okay, Okay, of all times I didn't make that one. Wow. Okay, of course. After every mishap, we can all... Here... Now, we're gonna go ahead and be getting into what those face paintings... What those ancient... walls say. What you gotta do here is blow that up. We see a switch here. Now, looking at those faces over there, look how they're arranged. Is it coming together now? So, what you gotta do is, wherever that face is right there, that is what you gotta hit. You gotta hit it in that order. So, we basically hit that first. And then the one over here. The one over here second. The one over here second. And that one over there. Alley-oop. Alright, and now we shoot this crystal right here, and boom. There we are. The door's open. And we got one more trial ahead of us before we can get our boss key, because... not boss key, but our craving now. Carving. They're not called boss keys in this game, they're carvings, basically. Let's see how long I can go in it. Okay. We got two of these guys that are going to be guarding their way. Let's see how... I did pretty well with these guys. Let's see how I can do with this. Okay. Don't jump on me. Okay, there we go. Uh-oh. I want to go hard on you. Okay. He's down. What? I thought I took both of them out. Come on. Game on me. Okay, there we go. Alright, that's more better. Alright. There we go. There we go. Now we're getting somewhere. And yeah, we've definitely made some good progress. Because our carving's in here. And here we are, we got an ancient circuit. It's made of shining gold and looks like it may be part of something. And with that, we got a shortcut we can take, and there's only one thing left to do, and it's get the heck out of here. Couldn't describe it any other way. No, seriously, I really couldn't. And I've made that jump very successfully. Out of pure luck and stupidity. Folks, don't try that at home. And with this being said, we have made some good progress. So next time on the Let's Play of Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword, it's time we go and take on the boss, and hopefully we will find Zelda. See you guys then.